All right. I'm making this quick video because I was in love with the Control S8 when it first came out, and I was really excited to finally get a hold of one. And right before I went to pick it up, we had just tons and tons of bad reviews on it, tons and tons of people claiming that it's locking up, it's crashing, it's, you know, controller response isn't mapped properly. There was bad channel pods in some of them, faders, something on about the screens didn't refresh correctly, and it scared me to death, and I didn't even want to spend my money and waste my time dealing with crap that's not ready for the market, and it really let me down. I really thought Native Instruments of all companies would have had this shit ready to go and almost didn't buy it. And then the guy selling it was so frustrated with it, he dropped his price a lot. And that let me get it for really cheap. We'll say that. So, got the controller. He scratched off the serial number on the back, which is no big deal because I didn't need Traktor software. I had it already. And that leads me to my first negative comment about the Traktor experience, is that I am a Traktor user since it was Final Scratch, and I have bought that software, I think, about 3 times now. I have 3 different registrations in my support, Native Instruments support software, but neither 3 of them would qualify to use the controllers, so I had to buy it yet a third time for $9.99. Best $100, by the way, I've ever spent on any software. It's worth it. I'll buy it 3 more times if they need me to. I just think it's fucking stupid. Anyway, so back to getting the controller home. Once I tested it on site, I actually did a Chick-fil-A drive-by and stopped in a Chick-fil-A. He brought the controller, plugged it into my Traktor Pro, which was running, I think, 2.1, real beginning of 2, and I hadn't updated it in a while because if it ain't broke, don't fix it. That's key. Don't fix it if it ain't broke. So it worked. About 5-10 minutes, we tried it out. Cool. Brought it home, hooked it to the studio, same laptop, started playing around with the remix decks, and then I believe I had my first crash. Then I went right immediately, like, let's just get everything up to date. Updated my new drivers for this. Went to the software, found out there was 2.10, which solved a lot of problems, I believe, with some of the screen stuff. So I did that. Then I learned from another chat board that you have to calibrate these controls, especially if you're updating software. So it makes you go through and do a calibration on all of the buttons. And once you do that, along with the firmware, and along with updating Native Instruments Traktor Pro to the latest version available to the website, you have a successful, just what they call it, a mothership. This is pretty much the best controller I've ever played with in my whole life. Seriously. It's worth every penny of it. I'd pay $12.99 right now. If this one shorts out, I will run to the store and buy a brand new one. I am addicted to it, and not going to talk anymore. I'm going to show you just some quick features. I just launch the software, turn on the controller. Whether I turn off the controller and turn it back on while the software's on, it just syncs itself back up. Number one best part of anything Native Instruments, they think about that shit. They think about things getting unplugged accidentally or needing to be rebooted, and they sync back up. Including all of where I love to keep my effects knobs every time I DJ, my starting points. When the software loads up, it looks at the controller and says, that's where his knobs are, and puts them there, instead of making me refresh every knob before a show. Nothing more annoying than turning on echo and finding out it's at full blast and scrambling really quick to not sound stupid. So, just basics. It says no track loaded. The browse button, you press it, brings up your categories just like you set up in your decks. I can get to my remix decks. I can get to see all tracks, and I'll just load one up. Click, boom, puts it in deck B, which is confusing for some people, A, B, C, D. Not confusing for me because I've always looked at Traktor thinking about 1, 2, 3, 4 and whatever. So biggest gripe about this controller is there's no jog wheels, there's no pitch bend, there's no tempo jobs. Well, there's tempo adjustment for each individual deck, but the idea is to get into your music and find the songs that aren't analyzed properly and fix them so that you can perform something that is all synced together. That's what this whole controller was designed about. Fix your music and then allow the player to, if you would, manage all of your sync issues. And then you're just fine-tuning, which for fine-tuning, I find this to be the best use of real estate. I can press on it and speed up the song a little bit. I can press on it here and slow it down a lot. And then it acts as a cursor, so I can move it, just like the record or jog wheel, which is important. So in the controller, you can't see because I'm not fancy with gaming cameras, but I can get it right up to that little point there and lock it in. So once I have the cursor where I want it, and I don't use snap mode normally. I just like the controller to be the controller, and then I'll choose when I want it to sync things or not. I disable those two things for the start, and now I have my cue point. Now, I will say the pads on this is not your MPC. It's not your Ableton push controller over there. Definitely not even as nice as the Machine Micro's keys, but they remind me of the Micro as far as if you don't hit that pad in the center and you don't hit it hard, it sometimes misses. So not my favorite. I wish I could adjust the sensitivity of these, and maybe they can and will in the future, but I'd like to be able to adjust sensitivity of the drum pads. One thing. So I got my cue part, just start playing. And the idea is, Traktor's gonna know 128. If I wanna speed it up from here, master tempo right in the middle. I can do a fine increment, or I can hold down shift. And I can go up in increments of like 1. Or back down. Original tempo of this song, right at 1. There we go, dial right in, and then we would start the next track, no problems at all, very fluent in loading a song, not crashing my screen. It uses up, I think, a lot less resources moving around the software than even the mouse does. I mean, if I go over here and mouse into my library, it'll hiccup for a second. So load up the next track, no pauses, no quirks, get to that first beat, and I'm honestly not even listening to the cue with this because I know that song's grid line it up. Turn on sync, and have some fun. All right, so this brings me to my next thing. The filters on this controller are seriously some of the best I've ever heard. And not just the way they sound, but the way they react. And mind you, my laptop's not super beefy. It's not a huge laptop with 16 gigs of RAM and quad-core processor. It's a ThinkPad T-Series 420 Lenovo. 8 gigs of RAM, i5, not even i7, and just plays fine. You just have to strip Windows of all of its processes. So once you get that done, and that's some message boards for you kids, just use a script. Don't try to do it yourself. Find a reliable script, and there's plenty out there. Clean Bat, I believe, is one. And just double click and boom, solves your problems. End of discussion. Makes PCs able to be used for live performances. So getting back to the controller, we're rocking. Both these songs are still synced. Isn't that fucking crazy? All right, next thing I want to talk about, limiter. All right, limiter built into this is different than any of the other ones. They did something different with this because there's no more adjustment to the headroom. It just knows. So, in other words, if I bury just two tracks and I'm only playing really one or a little bit of another, it's not going to turn the limiter on as much, in my opinion, from what I hear. As I get multiple sample decks rolled up and I start going crazy with everything, it really sounds good. The end result is not affected by your average listener, what they're listening to in the music. Did a great job with the limiter. Tied in all the channels with the limiter, so even the microphone right now, I can bury the microphone. Still gonna keep everything balanced, even with music up. Come on! I mean, that's just fucking amazing. Okay, so great job on that. Great job on the screens. Easy to read, not ultra too bright that hurt your neck, and no twist angle to it. It's all flush. It's all good. All the buttons, click, 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 click. Knobs are real smooth, have some resistance behind them. I didn't get the chroma key caps because the touch sensitive parts of the knobs won't be affected. So I don't want to cut the functionality just for colorful knobs, but they did a beautiful job. This controller is beautiful. It is made solid. There is a little bit of weight. Everybody's like, oh my God, there's so much weight. It's still, think of it as a solid four-channel audio interface, professional quality, balanced outs, booth outs, turntable input, preamps, two microphone inputs, which that's my next gripe. Microphone inputs, okay? They are routed to a channel on your mixer. So that's cool because then everything can be synced, including your echo. Or echo. Or echo. Or echo. That, so, and I mean, it's still there. It's still there. It's still there. It's still there. I mean, and then again, we can just affect my voice and not the music. So not the music. 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 Which comes in All right, so everything's synced in together real good. Accessing loops is just so cool, so quick. I can adjust that loop on the fly or jump around. Crazy. And this quick, ready? Boom, raise your weapon, play. I'm telling you, loads tracks so fast, and I don't have a solid state drive. It would perform so much better if I did, but external USB 2.0 drive, just a Seagate, and that's what I'm using. Just, you know, the not the worst, not the best, but in the middle, and blew my mind. So let me show you the remix decks real quick, and then we're gonna cut this video kind of short. So to get into your remix decks or any of the other two decks, all you have to do is press this button, and then that will load you into your remix deck. So deck D. Right now deck D comes up as a regular track because I blanked it out. That was stupid. And turn it back into remix deck, and then you have the four blocks. Well, from here, if I hit browse, I go back. In track collection, they have remix sets for you. And I saved one because my corrupted problem in my database from when I updated everything, it kind of messed it up. So I had to go in and, fix my library, which is after you update your Traktor software, you got to go in and rebuild your library because it does some changes to it. So that's another problem I had. It kept crashing when I would go to close out, and it wouldn't save any of my remix sets. Again, use the forums. That's why they're there. Here we go. Here's the remix deck. We're going to turn up D. And then we're going to have these four faders to play with, these four ideas that are actually these other four ideas. Ready? Up. And right off the bat, I made a mistake. I did not hit the sync button down. Just like these decks, if I want this loop to be synced and not to be free, I need to sync it. So let's stop. Goes back to the part of the cue in every single one of these loops. Hit sync. Now let's start that percussion up. Isn't that amazing? And now just like a deck, I can mix it. Look at that. I just fixed it. I didn't have to do all this. It's DJs are hurt, and I understand. We like to play with things, so it did take a little bit of the action fun of moving my arms around, but it was quicker to just make that adjustment being right here near the pad. So here comes the other sample. There, or I could load up another remix deck, but I could just have some fun with this right now. So I've got four pads on here that are house beats, and then four pads that are break beats. So no matter what song I'm kind of playing, I can kind of transition in between something else. And I'll play with this stuff while I figure out what I'm going to play over on this other deck, which is what I kind of like about this controller. Buys you some time here. Let's go into top 40 tracks. And then I want to sort, so I just spin this knob. I don't have to grab the mouse now. I don't have to look at that damn computer. And we're at 128, so here we go. Okay, Rihanna, let's do it. And there it is, it's ready. I'm gonna set a hot cue point. This is why I don't like snap, by the way. If you wanna tap it in like I do, take sync off. And then I'll set up a loop. Individual filters on all four of those channels. And then a kill. What it takes to form a life. And then I could go into completely different patterns and bring them back in. And it's gonna limit me being loud on the mic, trying to cover this up. And it does that ducking, I know that you're hearing. Ready? I messed that one up. So the idea is these remix decks really just keep going to whatever you've got them synced to. whatever you load them. I just chose percussion loops, but they could be one part bass kicks. Bow, 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 bow. And they're always there to bring them back in. So next part about this, remix decks are really fun. It's got some freeze functions. I'm not going to go over that. You'll figure it out as soon as you press it one time. Everybody spends time on shit. Doesn't matter. Filter kills on each one of these. So they are locking to zero and then they turn off and on for you. But you can also kill them. Cue buttons are nice and big and easy to hit. Preamp in this. Amazing. I know the older controllers, they complain it's not loud enough. It is more than loud enough. You are deaf if it is not. Get a nice pair of headphones and you'll be fine. And all the connections are awesome in the back, but the only problem with the way it works is that that microphone 1 and 2 should have been post-mixed right to the master and not to the booth out. I don't know why it is, because it comes through the channel. There's no way to not have it come through the channel. So that's one problem. And I probably was so they could limit just having 4 channels active at one time instead of 6 or possibly 5. So that's the only hardware gripe on it. For the studio, there's many workarounds, you know, with the interfaces and stuff that you have available. So, not a showstopper for me. And I'll be honest, that's all I'm going to say about it. The effects, are the effects in here 100% right on the money? The overall sound quality. Never mind my microphone. Never mind the hiss that we get from my microphone, because it's going through a kind of like a
voice changer,
and it lets me play with my voice however I feel that's necessary. Sometimes I just need to
pick myself up a little bit.
So, crystal clean. When all faders are down, you do not hear hiss. You do not hear anything. And some of my booth master, I noticed, almost doesn't become active until it's loud enough to be really heard through my tiny portable JBL speaker. That's my booth monitor now, which is hilarious. So, overall, this controller is a few months old. It has been used improperly for a while and now used properly and works like a charm. I will be putting more videos up. I will get better at using this, and I hope Native Instruments gets some of those bad videos offline and people start listening to what's good. And try it out for yourself, guys. Not everybody online takes the time to, you know, get all the correct drivers and do the research before they go online and start streaming shit in their opinion. So, peace out. Buy one, seriously.